these mirrors for our putter fitting. We can also order them. Mm-hmm. We sell mirrors like there.
Mm-hmm. I mean, we'd be glad to sell you a mirror for $40. Mm-hmm. My wife sent me down to Dollar Tree a few years ago to buy some candles. Mm-hmm. My mother-in-law was visiting. Mm-hmm. And they have these mirrored candle holders down there. Have you ever seen those? Mirrored candle holders. Mm-hmm. And so I just bought a couple of those. I keep one back in my teaching area. I got an extra one at home. Mm-hmm. That's what I'll use at home. So I'll put my ball right at the front of the mirrored candle holder like that. And it's only about that long, about that big. Besides that, the other feature about this mirror, though, is it has the red line on it, and then it has red lines down there. So when I stand over the ball, I'm too far away. My eyes are right down at this line. I need to move closer where my eyes are bisecting the red line with the black arrow. And then I can see my shoulders. Okay. So we want to get your shoulders square. So in mechanics of setup, we'd want your eyes over the ball. I generally like people to have a square stance as opposed to open stance with their feet or closed stance with their feet. But if you did have an open stance with your feet or a closed stance with your feet, you would still want to have square shoulders. You might have heard of a tour player named Briney Baird.